It's time for another RIN TV Rewind, where we look back at highlights from RIN TV over the first 6 months of 2014. At the annual RIMS conference in Denver, the Affordable Care Act got a lot of attention. Here, Chris Williams, the Fiduciary Product Lead at Travelers, warned that employers don't understand their exposures under the ACA. His report was one of the most popular stories of 2014 so far.
Travelers recently conducted a survey on the ACA and employers' responses to same. The purpose was really twofold. First, we wanted to get a sense of what employers thought and what they were doing with regard to the Affordable Care Act. And second, based on those responses, we really wanted it to serve as a call to action for employers on next steps and potential steps they should take to avoid management liability exposures. Interestingly, in the survey, one of the things we found out was that 36% of respondents are not at all or not very familiar with their obligations under the PPACA. An additional 31% were only somewhat familiar. Furthermore, 25% had not yet started doing anything to prepare for the PPACA. And in addition, I would just note that many respondents weren't familiar with some of their management liability exposures under the Act. I think many employers aren't quite ready because they don't understand what their exposures are under the PPACA. For example, 47% of the respondents weren't familiar with the whistleblower protections afforded to their employees. One of the things that was really interesting to us was that for those employers that were extremely familiar with the PPACA, they were three times more likely to be concerned about employee lawsuits. So that suggests that the more familiar employers are with the PPACA, obviously the more concerned they are about litigation going forward. In addition to sort of suits by employees, the PPACA also presents some penalty exposures. For example, under Section 1104 of the PPACA, employers have to certify that their data and information systems are in compliance. I would also note they have to certify to the Secretary of Health and Human Services whether or not the benefits they provide meets the minimum essential requirements. And the failure to do the latter could result in a $100 per employee penalty. At Travelers, one of the things we've done to help our insureds out in these cases is we've provided a risk management toolkit. And that toolkit consists of some white papers providing an explanation of employers' obligations under the Act, an overview of some of the potential exposures, some frequently asked questions and responses, a model employer notice, and we've also provided a hotline to our insureds, to our management liability insureds, to reach out through the law firm of LeClaire Ryan that can provide them guidance on the Affordable Care Act. In addition, I would just note the risk managers, I would encourage them to reach out to their brokers about EPL, D&O, and fiduciary coverage, which can provide protection in the event of lawsuits by employees, shareholders, or creditors.
Throughout July, we are rewinding highlights of popular reports from the last 6 months, all viewable from our on-demand library. So keep it here for even more world risk and insurance news on RIN TV.